Hey guys, GamerLCD here, and for today's video, we're going to be doing a little bit of Myst to Pandaria release date theory crafting. So yes, this is going to be another podcast video. It's not going to go into my Gamer's Rant series, because like I said in the previous videos, my Gamer's Rants videos are usually 25 to 35 minutes long, and for this, it's only going to be about 5 to 10 minutes, so this won't be going into my Gamer's Rant series. But basically, a lot of people have been asking, and they've been tossing around all these ideas about when Myst to Pandaria is going to be released, and they've been wondering, and Blizzard really hasn't come out and told us anything yet. But they've been doing a lot of things lately that gives us a lot of hints and clues about when we can expect a release date announcement or even the game being launched in itself. So what I want to do in this video is just talk for about 5 and 10 minutes and just go over all these ideas and what Blizzard's been doing to give us hints and things like that. So let's go ahead and get started. So first up, I just wanted to go a little ways back and actually bring up a statement that Blizzard gave to us at BlizzCon 2011. So this was after Cataclysm had launched back in December 7th of 2010. And basically in this statement, they said that they wanted to push out expansions faster than they had been before. So I believe we were getting expansions every 2 years, and they said that they wanted to push out an expansion every year. And with Cataclysm being launched in December 7th of 2010, we're coming very, very close to that two-year mark when it comes to releasing Myst of Pandaria. So even though we have about five and a half months until December, it really is a really, really long time between the release of Dragon Soul and the actual release of the next expansion, Dragon Soul being the very last raid of the expansion. Basically, my opinion on this is that Blizzard has not kept up with their promise, but I will cut them some slack, because the next thing I wanted to talk about was the fact that they have been putting a lot more features than they had originally planned into this expansion that weren't originally planned, as I said. So what that does is that slows down development time, and basically I can't really wrong them for this, because they really wanted to give us a really complete, polished expansion. And I really can't fault them for that, for wanting to give us the best content that we can possibly receive on launch day. And I think a lot of people will agree with me on that, being that they want the best possible game that they can get. Myst of Pandaria did come out, or the Myst of Pandaria beta came out to the middle of March, I believe it was. So we're about 4.5 months into the beta so far, and they have recently been doing a lot of raid testing. Lately, I'm pretty sure they've tested almost every boss that they can test in the raid area. 10-man normal modes, they haven't really done much of 25s yet, and they haven't done any heroic testing, but the majority of all the raid bosses have been done. I think they have like one more boss that they have to test in the recording of this video. I could be wrong, but just recently they also started testing the very first challenge mode. So you know, once they start testing, now that all the raids are finished testing, now that they can test the other features like challenge modes and pet battles, which was the other thing I wanted to mention, was that the pet battles just came out in the recent patch last night. So they have like one more feature to test, and I think that is they have a couple of more scenarios to test, and then they have a challenge modes of all the dungeons that they need to test. So having said all of that, we're probably about another month or so of beta, and then we'll probably get a release date. A lot of other things that I wanted to talk about real quick. One of which was that PTR patch 5.0, it was just come out. So if you don't have access to the Myst of Pandaria beta, you can access patch 5.0 on the PTR, which basically is the pre-patch to Myst of Pandaria that will go on live servers here probably in a few weeks. Blizzard said that if you have access to the Myst of Pandaria beta, you will not have access to the patch 5.0 PTR, basically due to the fact that the PTR and the beta realms are all messed up right now. So if you have access to the beta, you will not have access to the PTR, and that's just how that works. That was a little side note that I threw in there, but back to business. I wanted to bring up the point that We have been raiding Dragon Soul for quite a while now. I can't give you an exact date about when Dragon Soul came out, but it has been a while. I'm actually looking at my armory right now, and I have a lot of Morchok kills. I have 23 normal mode Morchok kills and 15 heroic Morchok kills. So we have been raiding Dragon Soul for quite a while. I'd probably say about 5 or 6 months we've been raiding Dragon Soul. Not to mention the fact that they just, this coming Tuesday, they're pushing out the 30% nerf to all the bosses and damage to the Dragon Soul monsters. So that just goes to show you how long we have actually been raiding Dragon Soul. And I'm pretty sure everyone is burnt out at this point. I know my guild has stopped farming heroic Dragon Soul for quite a while now, and things are starting to get really, really boring. So back to business. The thing I wanted to talk about was the fact that Blizzard is trying to give us so many, they're trying to bring us back into the game because they know they have made us raid Dragon Soul for too long now, and they said many, many, many times that they don't want to give us any more filler content. They don't want us to give a filler raid or any more filler anything. So basically that we're left with Dragon Soul for the remainder of Cataclysm until they actually release Mist of Pandaria. So basically what Blizzard has been doing to help us along with our boredom is basically give us a whole bunch of things to do called summer challenges. And basically what they do once a week, they're giving us a new challenge. They're making us visit all these old raids. So they told us summer challenge, go raid Black Temple. Summer challenge, go raid Ulduar. Summer challenge, go raid Naxx or something like that. So they really want us to come back and actually do all of this old content that we've already done many, 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 many times before in the past, and probably give us something else to do while we kind of are being burnt out on Dragon Soul, which I can't really fault them for. But at this point, I would have expected some kind of filler content. But like I said earlier, I really can't fault Blizzard for giving us delayed Mist of Pandaria, because they really are trying to give us a Apollos expansion. But the fact that they didn't know beforehand that it was probably going to take this long, which is why they're giving us all this filler content like Summer Challenges and things like that. Another program that they're trying to get us into is the Guild Mentoring Program that was just mentioned about 4 days ago, or posted on the official site. And basically what this program is for is a guild program on low population realms. And basically you invite new players into your already established guild on that server. And basically you get it like MVP status on the forums and things like that for helping out fellow members of the WoW community who might be just joining the game and don't want to feel left out when it comes to MOP. The program is going to run for 4 months. I'm kind of getting off sidetrack here a little bit, so I'm just going to go ahead and move on. But like I said, they're giving us all this filler content to do. The other thing I wanted to mention was that they're giving us a ton, and when I say a ton, I mean a ton of discounts and deals on things. Like last week they gave us, I think it was a week and a half ago, that they gave us a $10 expansion. So you can get Cataclysm for $10, you get Wrath of the Lich King for $10, and you can get Vanilla and Burning Crusade for $10. So not to mention that this week they're giving us discounts on faction changes. So you can need a faction, a normal price for a faction change would be $30, but now they want us to give us a faction change for 25% off. So math hurts me, so I won't be tempted to do 25% of $30, but you guys get the point. They're trying to give us more and more and more things to do, because I know if you're getting bored of your faction, you can faction change to the Alliance or Horde or whatever faction you are currently. And then they're just trying to give us more and more things to do while we wait for Mist of Pandaria. Another thing I wanted to bring up was the fact that I think it was a couple weeks ago. Let me see here. It was 2 weeks ago. Yeah, it was about 2 weeks ago that two and a half weeks ago. They made a post on the official site that they're going to be showing off the Mist of Pandaria opening cinematic at GamesCon. And GamesCon is from August 15th to the 19th. So that's over a month away. So the fact that they're not even going to give us a release date between now and GamesCon in August just goes to show you how far off we are from this expansion. But who knows, we could get a release date announcement before GamesCon, and they're just going to show off the cinematic trailer at GamesCon. So you never know with Blizzard. We could get the release date tonight or tomorrow, you never know. But I will say that the release date is very, very, very close to being announced. I mean, like I said earlier in this podcast, they have finished testing all the raids. They finished testing most of the scenarios, and basically all they have to do is test now is the challenge modes, and the pet battles were just introduced in this latest patch last night. So, and it's pretty complete pet battle system. I mean, it's really polished, and there's still, like anything in the beta, it has bugs, but those are going to be ironed out very soon. Not many very class changes are going into the latest patches in the beta, so that just goes to show you how close we are getting to this expansion. I know I said earlier that we're kind of far off, but in reality, we're very close. I mean, we're close to release date, and we're also close to the expansion. If you guys, going way back to a released product slate that someone posted on the internet, which I will mention happens to be 100% correct so far, except for the fact of the Diablo 3 incident and the WoW movie, it has been spot on with all the releases so far. So, I can't really go use it for Mista Pandaria because we're kind of past that launch date too. But everything else on there was spot on. But we were expected to get like an August release date for Mista Pandaria. That's not happening. That is simply not happening. I think that if they announce a release date in July, sometime in July, we will see Mista Pandaria end of August, early September. That's just how I see it. There's really not much else to say about this this topic. I mean, Blizzard is working very, very hard to bring out this expansion in a timely manner. As long as we don't hit 2 years, I'm happy because I have really absolutely nothing to do with my life right now. I go to work, and that's about it. I can't even play Diablo 3 because that game is just ridiculously retarded right now. And I have nothing to do in WoW because Dragon Souls boring. So I don't know what you guys have. I don't know if you guys have any thoughts and opinions on this. If you guys have any inside information that I don't. But this video is just about theory crafting and bringing up all this stuff that Blizzard has been hinting at and things that Blizzard have been giving us to give us hints on when then we can expect a release date. But I've mentioned all the major stuff. If there's anything I'm missing, go ahead and let me know in the YouTube comments below. And, that's going to wrap up this video podcast, guys. My name's GamerLCD. If you like more content like this, go ahead and hit the like button and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Also, check out my live stream at twitch.tv/GamerLCD, where I live stream all my video games that I play and give out contests and gold and things like that. That's going to wrap it up. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time.